There's other breaking news right now involving the longtime Trump advisor and associate Roger Stone. Our senior congressional correspondent Manu Raju is joining us from Capitol Hill. Manu, update our viewers on the very latest.
Yeah, that's right. Roger Stone, one of the president's closest associates, someone who has come under enormous scrutiny in recent weeks and months by special counsel Robert Mueller's team, who's been looking into his contacts that may have occurred in 2016 with WikiLeaks. Now, there's been a separate effort by the Democrats on Capitol Hill to learn more about those contacts that may have occurred between Roger Stone and WikiLeaks, and for him to produce a range of records. Now, just moments ago, Wolf, Roger Stone sent a letter to Dianne Feinstein, who's a ranking Democrat on the Senate Judiciary Committee, and said that his attorney said that he would not provide this information to the committee because he was pleading the Fifth. Now, a quote from that letter says, Mr. Stone's invocation of his Fifth Amendment privilege must be understood by all to be the assertion of a constitutional right by an innocent citizen who denounces secrecy. Now, what Stone says, Stone's attorney says in that letter is that he has already testified before the House Intelligence Committee, answered a range of questions, and that those transcripts should be available soon, either publicly, or the Democrats have said when they take power in the House that they will provide those transcripts to Robert Mueller's team. But Democrats will say that Roger Stone has not been fully truthful to the committee, not explaining the extent to which he tried to get information about the WikiLeaks hacks and the leaks of the Clinton emails during the 2016 campaign. And they have a lot more questions. But a significant revelation by Stone's team tonight, saying that they would take the Fifth Amendment by not responding to these questions to Dianne Feinstein. Also interesting that they would choose to say that, because a lot of other people who Feinstein has reached out to have essentially ignored her request, because in as a minority member, Wolf, she does not have subpoena power the way that a Republican chairman would have, at least in the House side. So this is a decision by them to make it very clear that they're not going to provide this information to Congress, perhaps assigned to this House Democrats when they take power next year, that if they want to subpoena Roger Stone, they may have a fight on their hands going forward. We'll see what Robert Mueller's team decides to do. Right now, we don't believe he has had contact with Roger Stone, but of course he's had contact with a lot of those Stone associates, and we'll see what the next steps Mueller's team takes to go after Roger Stone, Wolf.
What's intriguing, this decision by Roger Stone and his attorneys to cite their Fifth Amendment, his Fifth Amendment privilege, not to appear before the committee, not to present documents before the committee, follows only by one day what the president of the United States said about Roger Stone. Let me read this tweet to you and to our viewers. I will never testify against Trump. This statement was recently made by Roger Stone, essentially stating that he will not be forced by a rogue and out-of-control prosecutor to make up lies and stories about President Trump. Nice to know that some people still have guts. So what are they saying, if anything, on Capitol Hill? I know the news just broke that what Roger Stone is now doing comes the day after the president, in a truly extraordinary statement, defended him.
Yeah, that's a remarkable statement that was made by the president yesterday. Democrats have pushed back pretty aggressively towards what the president is saying, essentially sounding like he's dangling a pardon for Roger Stone, urging him not to cooperate with the special counsel as he went after Michael Cohen for cooperating with the special counsel. We have not heard much pushback from Republicans about that yet, not today, not yesterday. Now, a lot of members have not been in session because of the Bush funeral, and they've scrapped their schedule for most of this week. So we have not heard much reaction to that yet, and most Republicans have sided with this president, and this increasingly so as he's gone after the special counsel. But Wolf, this will only re-energize efforts by Democrats and some Republicans to try to protect the special counsel, try to potentially move on legislation to ensure he is not influenced by political pressure. So far, of course, the majority leader, Mitch McConnell, has not wanted to move forward on that. But the president's tweet, interesting timing for this letter to come out soon after, saying that he would assert his Fifth Amendment rights. We'll see if Roger Stone decides to do that, if he is in fact called for by the special counsel or is forced to testify before a grand jury.
Clearly, President Trump strongly supports Roger Stone and his legal efforts, although it's a bit awkward, Manu, as you know. Remember what President Trump and candidate Trump used to say about individuals who were being investigated, Democrats at the time, by Comey, the FBI, and others, members of Congress, what the president used to say about those who plead the fifth. Listen to this.
Have you seen what's going on in front of Congress? Fifth Amendment, Fifth Amendment, Fifth Amendment. Horrible. Horrible.
The mob takes the fifth. If you're innocent, why are you taking the Fifth Amendment?
When you have your staff taking the Fifth Amendment, taking the fifth so they're not prosecuted, I think it's disgraceful.
That's pretty awkward enough for the president, having said that and now seeing one of his close associates plead the fifth.
Yeah, no question about it, Wolf. He has time and again said things on the campaign trail that have come back to show, embarrass the president or embarrass the White House, saying things like these are some of the, he only hires the most talented people, the people who are the best people for his campaign. And we've seen one aide after another advisor either plead the fifth, some pleading guilty to lying to the FBI. It shows the president's inner circle increasingly under pressure by the Mueller team and on Capitol Hill, only bound to intensify in the year ahead, Wolf.
Certainly will. All right, Manu Raju up on Capitol Hill.